machine. Machine consists of a parts which converts the useful energy to useful form or the other form. So now we are dealing with the kinematics of machines. So to define it, first we define about the elements. As machine consists of number of elements, we want to understand about what is an element. An element is also called as link. The link is a rigid body, and this link has relative motion with other bodies. Rigid body means a body that does not deform during the transmission of motion. But in nature, we cannot expect a complete rigid body. So we define the rigid body as resistant body. Resistant body means the body which does not, which deforms, but it can, but the deformation is negligible and it will transmit the required motion from one element to other element. So we define the link as a resistant body which has relative motion to the other link, and this is called as kinematic link. And when a link is connected to the other elements or other links, we call them as a link. So two elements are connected to each other and they are transmitting the relative motion, we call them as a pair of elements. And if this pair is called as kinematic pair, when it transmits the motion which is completely constrained, or successfully constrained. So here we discuss about what are the different types of motions. To understand about the motion, the pair of elements are following that particular motion or not. So coming to the next, we discuss about the types of motions. First one is completely constrained. And the second one which we say it as incompletely constrained. And the third one is successfully constrained. Coming to the first one, completely constrained, we say that when the relative motion between the two elements is in only one direction, and in the case of any direction of force applied, then we say it as completely